episode 2539, The Gift of Wisdom.
Moms, it's time to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew who you are in mind, body, and spirit. Welcome to Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, the show to help you do just that. Here's your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo.
Staring at a stop sign, watching people drive by.
Happy, happy day. Are you on countdown yet? Oh, come on. We are getting so close. Three more days till Christmas. And that means you only have 2.5 days left of shopping. Take a deep breath. You got this. But today, it's about you first. Healthy living. What is your lifestyle like? How are you treating yourself? It all comes from the gift of wisdom. For those of you who are brand new to Create You Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple strategy, everyday solutions to live, love, and impact. Well, this episode is brought to you by the AIM Academy. I first want to give a huge shout out. Number one, you are still in it to win it. You are here, you're listening, and that means that you matter to yourself. And it's very easy for us to put ourselves on the back burner. So I just want to say thank you for taking care of you. God gave us the gift of life. It is up to us to give ourselves the gift of living well. That's what the French philosopher Voltaire said. This comes from the gift of wisdom gained through a multitude of failures with greater success. And Lao Tzu said this, truly the greatest gift you have to give is that of your own self-transformation. But if we're honest, I mean really honest, it's hard, especially as we age. It takes dedication and consistency every day, and let's admit it, self-care is lacking in our world of immediate gratification and satisfaction. We put everybody else first. The quick fix syndrome is grooming our everyday living while rejecting the most important focus, well-being. We want to do everything for everybody else, but we won't take time for ourselves. But the thing is this, you get to create your now. Your body is a gift. Did you hear that? Your body is a gift. Are you unwrapping it like you need to be? And no, don't let your mind go there. That's for another episode. And you got to understand, it is up to you to take care of the body God has given to you. However, it's easy to miss this gift that's right in front of you. Because why? We don't open the package. We just let the hustle and bustle of the year cloud your priorities. And then you're caught putting fires out that honestly really don't matter in the long run. If you aren't willing to slow down in order to speed up, you can miss the gift of wisdom. What's right in front of you? So today I ask you, pause for yourself. Use this time to reflect on what you've gained throughout the year. That is your Kiss to Keep It Simple strategy. Reflect on what you've gained. I mean, who would have thought that gaining something would be positive when it comes to healthy living? Most of us are trying to lose that which has already been gained since Thanksgiving. I mean, come on, let's be real. How many pounds are you thinking you need to lose? And that you want to take off so it makes room for what's happening over the next week and a half to 2 weeks. This season, though, I don't want you to think about things in pounds. I want you to get to your heart. And I want you to consider two specific questions. Number one, what is the biggest lesson you've learned this year? There are always lessons to be learned. Yet most of the time, we let those lessons slip by us, not making a great impact. Well, today, it stops with you. Reflect on that big lesson that had you scratching your head in the moment, yet jumping for joy days, weeks, and months later. You know what I'm talking about. You've been there. And if you have more than one big lesson learned, make note of what they are. Pay attention to the progress of your transformation. Remember, this is a journey. It's not a sprint. It's a long marathon. And every day you get to get up and you get to decide. It's not, oh, I have to do this. No, you get to do it. So what stands out for you? Because this is where you will grow even more because of your awareness and due diligence. You matter. So what is that biggest lesson you've learned this year? It may be something really small. Wow, I really feel great when I drink all the water. Yeah, it still may be tough, but you know it works for your body. Or maybe you've discovered that eating before 10 o'clock in the morning really doesn't set you off right, even though you've been told for years, decades, that you need to have breakfast. And you're like, I've been forcing myself to eat forever. Or maybe you've decided that walking's better than running. What is it for you? What is the biggest lesson you've learned this year? And then number two, the question is, how do you want to apply the lesson learned to this coming new year? Notice I didn't say, hey, what's your New Year's resolutions when it comes to your healthy living? Because I want you to be specific about the lesson that you learned and how you're going to apply it this new year. Don't gloss over what you think will make do. That's been going on for many years now. Do your homework. Set yourself up for success so when failure comes knocking on your door again, because it will, you'll already have a game plan in motion. One step at a time leads to miles of greatness. I want you to think outside the box. Don't sit here and try to put yourself in somebody else's shoes. Today, the only shoes that fit are yours. That's what you need to be looking for. Not the red slippers. Not the ones that say, you know what? Gosh, this looks great. It's so tempting. No, you need to look at what works for you. What have you learned? We learn something from everyone who passes through our lives. Some lessons are painful. Some lessons are beautiful. But all are priceless. And it adds up to what we need to take away. What if we didn't always have to rely on 2020 hindsight because we're so aware, we're so in the moment, we're so present that we can make a switch literally in a blink of an eye? So don't be so quick to throw away those moments you wish didn't happen. They actually might serve a greater purpose in your journey of well-being. So what is it for you today? I want you to, dial back a little bit. What comes to mind immediately when you think about the biggest lesson learned? And how do you want to apply it? And maybe you need to tweak it a little bit. But you've got to get those juices flowing. No, I don't want you to think about the Christmas present you still have yet to buy. That will come, or maybe it won't. But you don't control that. What you do control is right now. And if you don't take care of your body, if you don't say, you know what, I matter, then what happens a year from now? Will you be worse off than where you are today? Will you be wishing, gosh darn it, if I just would have? Fill in the blank. Maybe you've been doing this for decades. I get the excuses. I've been there. I've done that. Very recently done that. To the point where these questions mean a lot to me too. Because I'm looking at my half century and I'm going, Lord, there's more. But if I don't have my health, there's nothing I can do that you want me to do. And so I've got to be willing to put the time in for me. And it's hard, especially as moms, as women. We've got complicated bodies. Men, I get you. You're complicated. But us women, have you heard? We bear children. And that is complicated enough. We have so many hormones, it's ridiculous. And when we have all of that wrapped up, and then we have nurture and nature, it gets very complicated to being a woman. And so for a moment, set aside some time, even if it's driving in between stoplights, when you're on the highway, running from one place to the next, put on some music where it just allows you to go somewhere else and say, you know what? What lesson have I learned? What has been really good for me? And maybe you need to also look at the lesson learned that what's been really bad for me. What didn't work? Because I don't want to go down that road again. You can gain a lot from that. But you have to be willing to be aware. You have to start being more in tune with your body. And that's getting to know yourself inside and out to the point where you know what these cells need. You know, I forgot to take my vitamins yesterday morning. And it was funny because I started to feel a little more sluggish in the afternoon. And it wasn't my typical kind of, if I could just get up and walk a little bit, have some more water, I'd be fine. No, it was like, whoa, I feel like I'm kind of coming to a brick wall here. And I don't usually do that. And I was like, I really need a nap. I'm like, no, I don't need a nap. I should be fine. I haven't done anything crazy like decorating my whole house. I already did that. It's beautiful. I don't have to worry about it. I get to enjoy it. But I was really feeling sluggish more than normal. I hadn't taken my vitamins. And there I was like, okay, now, Christine, you realize how important those vitamins are for you. And I do. I take them on a regular basis, and my body knows when I don't get it in. So I want you to be hypersensitive to what your body needs. Because when your body is totally in tune with where God wants you to be and your health becomes the priority, let me tell you, everything else begins to fall into place because you feel good. You have more energy. Sleeping, wow, it's awesome. Intimacy, rev it up. And then you have an attitude of, you know what? Nothing is impossible. You're not short with the kids. Your tone of voice changes. And when it's 8, 9 o'clock at night and the kids come running in after only being back at school for a week and a half and they're saying, home mom, by the way, I need this for school. I forgot to tell you, I'm so sorry. You don't blow off the handle. You simply smile and you're like, that's the life of being an awesome mom. And you get in the car and you run to the store real quick. You get what you need and you come home. And then you go to bed. It's totally different. But you see, you have got to take the steps now. You've got to start being hyper aware now. The gift of wisdom comes from knowing what you did not, yet looking to what you do now. Make this coming year extra special and unique to you. Create your now. Train for life. Love your journey. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a beautiful, blessed day and Merry Christmas. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.